So we've been doing this for a year. It's shocking how fast the year has gone, but we've given out $12,000 to people with great ideas in Calgary. And we've had hundreds of submissions from people, and the biggest part of this is to help support people in their ideas and to believe in them, and that's been phenomenal. Tonight we have our 45th, 46th, 47th, and 48th top four finalists. I'll introduce them in a minute, but first of all, our trustees. Starting at this end, we have Ken Sedgwick. We have Jennifer, who I introduced. We have John Smiley. We have Emma Grace May. We have our own Chris Salmon. Jeff Wilkie. And the guy who really, really pulled this all together for tonight, who I cannot live without his help, his team of volunteers, Reg Tianga. Our special honorary trustee, Mr. Mayor. We have Alan Montgomery, also known as our money man. Brian Singh. And Susan Poole, who is hiding in our second row. Susan, good to see you. So there's a chair for you right there. So hi, I'm scooching up there. So hi, I'm Lori, by the way, Lori Stewart. I'm the founder of this amazing thing that we've pulled off, but I could not. I could not have done this without the help and support of all of these people, all of our Twitter help, everybody who's part of this Calgary community that makes it awesome. I have a lot more people to thank. We have our Twitter team at the back. We have Sarah, Danelle. We have Tara. Oh. And Tara and Crystal. And maybe we should just hold the applause for a sec. So then we have our volunteers, Eleni, Alyssa Lynn, who's not here tonight with us, but Lisa Crosby, who I did see here. We haven't seen her in a while, so great to see you again, Lisa. We have Alex Kelly, we have Kelsey, we have Tony Grimes at the back, and Carl, and Pam Hyde, who is a new videographer volunteer for us. So thank you, everybody. So, we have a couple of very, very special team members here with us tonight. The most important job of the evening is timing. Our top four finalists get only 90 seconds to pitch their idea to us, and it's really important that we have accurate timing. So in that vein, we have our timers here tonight. We have Liam and Nolan Parmar. Stand up, guys, and say hi to everybody. So when our pitchers have 15 seconds left, they will get a visual signal. Nolan, can you light up your light? They'll get a signal that they have 15 seconds left. And when they run out of time, they get, go for it, Liam. They get gonged. Okay, so basically how it works is we've got our pitchers who come up, they pitch for 90 seconds, and then we go back and vote, and we do hand out $1,000 cash on the spot this evening. So because we are a little tight for time tonight, I think we're about ready to get going. Okay, and first up we have Chic Tyson and Ski Bike. Tony, are you good? Oh, you guys are not doing this.
I won't need that.
You won't need that.
We
need okay.
The internet.
Okay.
Do I get a countdown?
Five, four, three, two, one.
Hello, Awesome Calgary Foundation. My name is Chick Tyson, and these are my sons, Max and Quinn. Our idea is to mass produce an innovative new ski bike. Ski biking has been popular in Europe for over 40 years, and we think with the amount of enthusiasts for bicycling here, it's going to catch on really quick. I'm 51, and I have a lot of trouble keeping up with these guys on the hill. And I've also had some back problems, which have prohibited me from getting on the hill as well. I happened to be watching an old Beatles movie and saw them ski biking. I showed these guys, and they said, hey, let's come up with a kit to convert a mountain bike into a ski bike. So we did that at first. It was really easy to use. It was fun, but it was a little bit of a hassle taking it up the chairlift. Now, boys, knowing that my background is in steel fabrication, said, let's come up with an idea of a bike that can go on the chairlift easy. With this bike, you just remove the quick release pin, the bike collapses, and you simply rest the handlebars on your lap for the ride up the chairlift. When you get off, it only takes a second to put back together, and you're on your way back down the hill. This bike will not only give those people with non-debilitating injuries access to ski hills, but it's a lot of fun for all ages. If we were to receive $1,000, we would be able to purchase the equipment to start fabricating the ski bikes and get some professional help with our website. I've always thought it would be awesome to have a business with my sons. And with these ski bikes, I think we're on the right track. It was only 83 seconds in practice. I cut that kind of close.
Oh.
My phone for the web people. Great presentation.
Thank you.
How much would it cost per bike for the user at the end?
Well, the base model we're trying to keep below $1,000, which is comparable to a mid-level mountain bike.
And the conversion just to get the.
The conversion is $179 for just the kit. And with skis, it'll be around $350.
Hi, great presentation.
Thank you.
What's your timeline for this?
Our timeline?
For when you expect to be up and running.
Oh, well, we sort of are. I'm fortunate my brother-in-law has a welding shop, and I used to be a welder, so he lets me use it to start building the bikes and the prototypes and that. So we want to start making bikes for next year. I've actually got one order already. The first guy I showed it to, actually, I'll take one. So it was really nice to hear that kind of a response right off the bat.
Are they allowed on, like, Sunshine, Lake Louise, Fernie?
I'm not sure about Fernie yet, but in Europe, over 2,000 resorts accept them. Here in North America, it's about 72. COP, Lake Louise, Sunshine, Marmot Basin, all accept them. I haven't had a chance to check into the hills in BC yet, but hopefully we'll do some camping trips out there this summer and get a chance to talk to the people.
Well, I've never ski biked, and I wonder if I already know how to ski, how hard is it for me to learn how to ski bike?
Well, it's actually, if you just let the bike do all the work, if you don't, the first time I went down, I was trying to fight the bike. It's just go. Just
okay,
like
so
you're coasting on your bicycle. But when you go to stop, it's a combination of a hockey stop and a skiing stop.
Or you can
so
do
you just
the old.
Start the turn, and then you just push the ski out, and it'll dig in just like it does when you stop with your hockey skates or when you stop skiing.
Okay, so you've piqued my interest, and now I want to know, are these the same price or different price from ones I might be able to buy?
These are way less expensive. The other production bikes mostly come from Europe, and they start around 1,200 euro, which are about $1,600.
Okay,
we're going to make them here. We're not going to have them made overseas. We're going to make them right here in Calgary.
Wow, thank you. I think you've converted some skiers.
You should read the blogs because a lot of skiers and boarders who've tried it won't go back. You know, they like it so much.
Where do you source the ski part?
Like, do you guys make the skis part as well?
These skis?
Yeah.
No, we're actually getting them, going to get them out of the States. These are actually kid skis that you can use.
Okay.
With our conversion kits. Yeah, you can just make sure it's a twin tip ski and they work the best. But we do have some specialty skis that we're going to be bringing in from the States.
Okay.
Excellent. Okay, we have time for one more question. Anybody from the audience?
My question is just how do you get it on a chairlift?
Well, drop the pin out. Wait for the chair to come up underneath you. Rest the handlebars on your lap. Then you can text all your friends and tell them how awesome it is to ski bike. And you can Twitter and tweet, of course. Well, thank you very much for this opportunity.
Great job, guys. I think if you could get those up the stairs into here, you can probably get them easily on into. What about the gondola? Easily into the gondola?
We have to talk to the ski resorts regarding that, so I'll be doing the Mr. Nicey Nice tour this summer.
Can we please?
Excellent. Okay. Next up, we have Simon Rock and the Great Calgary Cookie Chase. No, you don't. But do you have? Do you have a presentation
no.
at all?
Do we have to use the microphone?
No? No? Oh, yes, you do because it's streaming.
Okay. Imagine it is a Saturday morning. You're at your favorite trendy coffee shop in Marteloup with a friend discussing your investments and stock portfolio. Out of the corner of your eye, you notice two giant cookies running down the street as fast as they can. Following them is a giant cookie monster trying to eat those cookies. And following all of this is a camera crew. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to make this cookie chase the next big viral video. We have a small scale demonstration of what it will look like.
Cookies!
Imagine that in your favorite Calgary areas with professional costumes. Now, we believe that with your investment, the project will grow geometrically and not linearly. However, the costumes will cost roughly $800, and the camera equipment costs $200. But with your help, we can have this project done by the end of July.
Now, we assume that you're all the type of people who spend their Saturday mornings in coffee shops checking your stock portfolio. So you're probably wondering, what are the types of awesome returns you can get from this awesome investment? And we have three for you today.
Number one is the spectacle. The excitement and joy brought to the people who witness this spectacle firsthand or on the internet will be groundbreaking for Calgary's cultural network.
Number two is Calgary itself. When you go on YouTube, the top 10 results if you search up Calgary are old tourism videos and songs about Calgary and stuff that no one really wants to watch. And we want something that will represent Calgary that everyone really wants to watch, and we think this is it.
Number three, you are investing in your youth. You are giving us and people who are inspired by us a chance to do what we love. And we believe that children are the future.
We believe the internet is the future.
And we believe the Cookie Monster is the future.
Thank you. I'm gonna be mean. That was great, guys. So $800 for the costumes, $200 for the camera. Does this involve any real cookies?
No.
It does now.
So no cookies will be harmed in the filming of this?
No, not at all. Don't worry.
So two questions. First question is, which one of you guys is the Cookie Monster? And the second question is, are you just planning on one run or several runs?
We'll have multiple runs throughout different areas in Calgary, like Kensington, 17th, Marteloup, Inglewood, all that kind of stuff.
Peace Bridge, yeah, Peace Bridge too.
Who's making your costumes?
The Cookie Monster costume, we have like a full-size mascot costume that we found on eBay. And do you want to explain about cookies?
The cookies is my mom is making them out of a foam latex resin it's going to be. So you can run in it and fall in it and it won't break and it will be very durable. Do backflips, that kind of stuff. Yeah.
So what are your timelines on this? Like, when would you run it? Approximately this summer, throughout the summer, that sort of thing?
We'd want to get it done through summer because that'd probably be when the areas would be most populated, more people outside to see it. Probably by the end of July is when we'd get it done.
I just want to know what sort of creepy things come up when you search eBay for full-size Cookie Monster mascot costumes.
None that we can talk about really.
Unfortunately, we cannot legally disclose that information right now, so I'm sorry, but yeah.
Could this be something that's ongoing? Like, could you come to events around the city and stuff like that?
Definitely, it could be a reoccurring kind of staple, I guess, if it was popular enough, definitely it could be.
Sweet, we'll talk.
So we know who the Cookie Monster is, we know who the cookie is. What's your role, Simon?
I would be, I guess, there to like help set it up, get people to get volunteers to help out with getting everything set up, probably just being the organizer or director.
So
we would find a bunch of friends who are interested in helping us out if we get the grant.
So you're saying you suckered your friends into wearing the goofy costume so that you could get the fame and glory? Is that about it?
It was my choice.
Oh, all right.
Oh, just to clarify, who's going to be doing the shooting again?
Any friends that are experienced with filming and are interested.
Could you potentially maybe say, probably a bit of a suggestion, but would you maybe say getting some broadcasting operation students, maybe from Mount Royal or, yes, Mount Royal, yay, or maybe say to do that for you as well? Maybe that's something that you could definitely explore.
Absolutely, if you're interested, we'd love to have help.
Great job, guys. Okay, next up is Vanessa and Stacy with Take Your Clothes Off Clothes Swap.
Hang on, we'll just move to the side, that's fine.
Yeah, ready.
Countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I'm Vanessa Erickson.
And I'm Stacy Savage. We're two best friends who love fashion, the environment, and Calgary. I'm a born and raised Calgarian, and Vanessa just bought her first house here.
We're the co-directors for the Calgary chapter of a nonprofit organization called the Swap Team, which hosts a giant clothing swap called Take Off Your Clothes. This event is great for the environment, benefits charity, encourages fashion and culture in the community, and last but not least, they're super fun and they're awesome.
So what is our concept? People bring their clothes to our event, which we set up like a giant boutique, and they can trade their pieces that they bring with the pieces that other attendees have brought. Leftover clothes are then donated to our charity partner, Goodwill Industries of Alberta. In its last 5 events, Calgary has seen over 20,000 pieces of clothing come in, and over 10,000 of which were donated to charity. This has in turn saved Calgary Swappers over $200,000.
Our June 3rd event is going to be our biggest yet. Our goal is to attract 400 people and 6,000 pieces of clothing. We've also scored a media partner, Avenue Magazine. Our challenge has always remained the same, finding a venue to fit us. With a larger event this year, we've decided to move to Hotel Arts, which they are kindly offering at a reduced cost.
As you can see, we run this event on a shoestring budget, leaning on our volunteers and sponsor donations. And in order to grow the swap and accommodate more attendees and therefore more clothes, we need a bigger venue, which costs money. This grant would help us pay for 2/3 of our venue costs, allowing for this event proceeds from this event to go towards venues and added features at future events. Thank you.
Any questions? No questions?
So I missed your, yeah, exactly. Yep. Where do your profits go, or if you call them profits?
So basically right now, any of the profits that we do have will go to feeding our volunteers. We have over 50 volunteers that help out. So feeding them lunch, any supplies that we might need. So we rent clothing racks, hangers, really just stuff to cover anything that's going to happen at the next event.
And how does it promote better fashion?
So, yeah, that's a good question. We actually get local boutiques and designers involved in the event, and we ask them to sponsor our event. You can see a couple of them are listed on our sponsor listing. They give us a piece of their clothing, or they give us their styling expertise or something like that to help us shoot our lookbook as well. The pieces that they donate, we raffle off at the event, and it goes towards our profits or our expenses.
I'm assuming that this is a ladies only event.
No, absolutely not. We invite women, men, everybody
men
to come.
Swap clothes?
Yeah, absolutely.
Get out.
No, I kid you not. I kid you not. And we're actually really.
Sorry, quick show of hands. What man has ever swapped clothes here? That guy.
Yeah! Woo, we know him. He volunteers at our event.
So what you're telling me is essentially it's a place where I can swap clothes as well, and also an outstanding place to meet women.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Do you take volunteers?
Yes.
Thank you.
I'll write down my information. You can send me an email. We'll get you a volunteering
Do we
position.
Take volunteers.
How many events have you had to date, and what's been the response?
So we've had, this will be our fifth event, and the response has been incredible. Our first event, I think, had about 400 people at the event. We've donated, like Stacey said, we've donated over 10,000 pieces of clothing. So the response has been phenomenal, and we literally, we're at a point where we can't grow anymore because we can't fit anymore in a building. So unless we have some money to put towards a venue.
So two questions. One is, I see your primary source of revenue is ticket sales. How much do you charge for tickets?
So this year we are charging $10 ahead of time at the door. On Eventbrite, and then we're charging $12 at the door. Or $15 entry will get you a eco bag that you can basically carry all of your swap pieces in.
So your revenue figures look a little low there. Is this for last year?
This was last year.
Okay, and last year you charged what?
$8 ahead of time and $10 at the door. Yeah.
Okay, and how do you market it to people? How do people know about it?
Our primary source of marketing is social media. So we do a lot of Facebook, Twitter. We have an outreach of about 15,000 people a week due to our Facebook page and everything like that. So it's been really phenomenal. And we are really working as much as we can with media partners. So Avenue Magazine, a lot of local fashion bloggers will write stories about us out to their followers, and a lot of online blasting.
We love web people. So what's your expected number of attendance this year? So have you forecasted, you know, what your spreadsheet looks like for this year?
We've looked at it. So our break even is, without this awesome foundation grant, is 300 people. So we do have some not much money left over, but we also have a national organization that has, in order to keep the Calgary chapter going, we have
a little bit of backing there that if we were to fall short, they would be able to cover us.
Excellent. Thanks. Any questions from the audience?
Hi, so I'm interested to know, if I bring jeans, do I get jeans back, or could I get jeans and a dress and a shirt? How does the swap part work?
It's exactly a one-for-one concept, so you can bring any of your pieces to us, and basically any of the pieces that you bring will get counted, and then you will get the allotted number of tickets, and then you can just go shopping, and you can get the exact same number of pieces to take with you. So you could swap jeans for a coat, or for a pair of shoes, anything like that. Yeah.
Hi there. I've just started training again, and I was a 365-pound strongman. I have a great deal of 4X shirts now in the closet. Do I get any extra tickets for 4X?
We can talk. We can talk.
Maybe if we upcycle them and create them into different clothes.
So I just have one final question. That's, do you take just straight donations of clothing? To add to your inventory.
Absolutely. So we would set aside a number of tickets for anybody who donates but is unable to make it, just in case there's a change in plans. But at the end of the day, we do. That's, you know, primarily why we have a lot left over to go to Goodwill. A lot of people do just want to donate, and they think it's a great outlet to donate to who can't make it to the event. Alternatively, a lot of people will come and donate 20 pieces and leave with 5 great pieces, and that's kind of where the surplus comes in.
Can I just add something? The Women in Need Society in the past has sent or people that aren't able to pay the fee or bring clothes, and we give them an allotted number of tickets. So, yeah, perfect. Okay. We haven't yet, but we're looking for more charity partners because we've lost.
And the walk-in closet.
Yeah. We will. Yeah.
Charity partners, absolutely.
And just one final question about why an indoor venue that costs money? What about a pop-up event?
We have strongly considered that. Unfortunately, we find that sometimes Calgary's weather is a little unpredictable. So we have thought about park space, open kind of public space. I think it would primarily depend on the timing of the event. In past events, we've had 2 per year, so a fall and a spring event to kind of coordinate with the fashion seasons. Mm-hmm. We are looking to moving to just 1 large event every year, so we could be a little bit more flexible with our timelines. It's probably something we'll talk about in the future. Yeah.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Oh.
Thank you.
Wrong mics. Thank you very much, Stacey and Vanessa. And our last but not least awesome idea of the month is Brenda and the awesome accordions. And they just need a few seconds to set up here.
I'm going to have to stand right here, I think. She'll probably hit me with the baton.
I'm going to be blown away here, am I?
What's that? You're going to be blown away, and I'm going to be talking like an auctioneer, so I can talk as fast as you can listen.
Thank you.
So
as soon as you start talking, I'll start counting and just go in. Okay?
You'll see the slide.
Second slide. Okay.
Second slide. Okay, this is the first one.
You'll get it in focus. My head's not moving.
And it'll focus. This is very serious.
Wow.
We're missing people. Yeah. Yeah.
705, Lori.
Okay. Okay. Huh? Yeah.
1 minute.
Wait. Oh.
Francesca, can I hear? Can you turn it up? Full heart. Okay.
Okay. Ready?
Countdown. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Brenda Turley with the Awesome Accordion Association of Calgary. We're a multicultural, multi-generational group of people who are proud of their choice of instrument and love to share their music. We're a nonprofit group happy to perform for the community. We've helped raise money for causes such as UNICEF and the Haitian Relief. We have shared the versatility of the accordion in the Calgary community in nursing homes, churches, and schools. We've played with the Bare Naked Ladies, Buckwheat Zydeco, performed at the Kennedy Center and at Knott's Berry Farm. We believe receiving this generous award would benefit both the people of Calgary, who will continue to enjoy the spectrum of music this versatile instrument can play, and the Accordion Association so as to inspire and motivate current and new players. We'll use half of the money over the next 2 years to establish awesome awards for individuals and groups. The other half would be used for promotional materials. We welcome all accordion players from the inexperienced to professionals. So don't be shy. Dust off that accordion in your closet and join us, the Accordion Association of Calgary. Hit it! Very much. This is Maureen Girosh, our conductor. Sorry, now my mouth won't work. And the president of our Accordion Association. So any questions she or I can answer.
Sorry, perhaps I got just too wrapped up in all the fabulous accordion music. What is the use of proceeds?
The use of the proceeds, we're going to use it towards scholarships and trophies. We have an annual music competition festival every June. So we would like to be able to have a trophy that has a scholarship in the awesome, they would be the awesome accordionist, and be able to hand it out to an individuals or groups.
If anybody parked in the no parking zone out front, there are tow trucks down there.
Which on the other side?
In front of the gallery.
What about the other side?
This side. There's BMW right there.
Oh. Did I do it? Did I do it? I don't know if they can hear me. That's okay.
So just for clarity then, how many scholarships are you talking about? Well, what's the actual dollar value that's being used?
We were going to put $500 towards scholarships and trophies for the next 2 years. The other $500 would be used for a banner and promotional material, because we have nothing professionally made other than a homemade job that says the Calgary Association, Accordion Association of Calgary, the Girosh Ensemble. So we're trying to be able to promote and look a little bit more professional.
Got it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Fantastic stuff. So how are people finding you now?
How do
people find you now to join you?
Well, we have a website. We have newsletters. We try to get us out into the public and play, like what we're doing right now. We're sabotaging you by playing for you to let you know we exist. It's very difficult because we do have to play indoors. Our instruments are very fragile for weather. And we play for free. We've played for the Alberta Centennial. We've played for the Calgary Philharmonic Children's Entertainment and Education Promotions. We've played with the Bare Naked Ladies on stage the last time they were in Calgary. We've played for opening for Buckwheat Zydeco. And in the future, we're going to be busking June 15th on Stevens Avenue at lunchtime so that everybody can hear us. We are competing as a musical entity at the Coupe Mondiale next year, which is the World Accordion Competition.
Like the Olympics.
And this will be the Accordion Olympics. Yeah. And we will be representing Calgary as well as Canada. We're one of the few accordion orchestras that exist in North America of this caliber. And we just want to do what we love passionately, but we need a little help once in a while.
Excellent. Any questions from the... I just wondered actually how you got to play at Knott's Berry Farm.
We did hear
that through the...
We were there for a competition, and the grounds or the parks asked if we would play.
Fabulous.
That was one of our slides that was up there. I don't know. They went by very quickly.
And I believe the mayor has a question.
I have two questions. The first is for the musicians. That was the most energetic conducting I have ever seen.
Yes.
Is she...
That's how she stays
thin. Is she always like that?
Yes.
What do you feed her? And you said that... Scotch. And you said that you can't do it outside, so I guess there's no hope of combining the accordion orchestra with, I don't know, a giant cookie and a monster chasing. I just feel like there's synergy here.
Well,
not on ski bikes.
We did do the big squeeze a couple of years ago, and as long as the weather's good, we're okay to play outside. If the wind blows, our music stands over. That's so we need roadies to lay around the bottom of the music stands to hold them.
Reg is available.
Okay. So in the wintertime, it's really hard. We have played for First Thursdays out in the core, and we try. We're trying to get you guys to know that we exist and that we love to play for you, and that's all we want. Our accordion festival is a community that has produced these musicians over the last 23 years. All of these people took lessons, competed, and played. Actually, right now, the Coupe Mondiale Junior competitor from last year who won in, I think it was Austria, is from Calgary. So we have created musicians that are world class.
So if I wanted you guys to play at a movie that I was showing on the side of a building, would you come out?
We would love to come out.
Excellent.
Yeah, we would love to come out.
No.
Okay. So I would just like to finish by saying that please remember behind every great accordion is an awesome accordionist, and you can be one too, because I took up accordion 3 years ago, so there's hope. Thank you very much.
Great, thank you. Now, are you guys
yes,
clearing?
We'll
clearing out, or you're staying set up?
If you want us to play again, we'll stay
we
set up.
We can play another song for you.
Okay. Well, hang on. We've got a few things to talk about. We need to deliberate.
Okay.
So,
thank you
guys, thank you very much. Great playing. You can take a rest for a second, but I think after we're done the awards, we can have you guys play a little bit. So, Matt Hamill, back there with the last question about whether or not you would play at an outdoor movie. Matt is one of our previous winners. He is the founder of YYC Mobile Movies, and he shows movies out in great outdoor spaces in Calgary on the sides of buildings for free, and it's a phenomenal way to get people together. Yeah, Matt, stand up. We we have a number of other awesome alumni here. I saw Kieran Samanchuk or Samanchi, wherever you are. Where are you? Oh, hey, Kieran. So Kieran was YYC Audio Mob, did a great job pulling close to 300 people together last Bow River Flow to a great choreographed...
hour-long flash mob.
Yeah. Excellent, excellent. One of the best things about Awesome is that we put people together that never ever would have come together in their lives before. Who knew that there were this many accordion players in the entire city of Calgary? Not me. So right now we get to go deliberate and pick a winner. It's always extremely difficult, and we always wish that we had, you know, $4,000 to hand out every month, but sadly we don't. But hopefully we've given everybody a little bit of exposure. So we're just a bunch of people who care about the city, and we like giving money away. So are there any accountants in the audience? Any bookkeepers? Great. Okay, you can just sit down, Jess. Thanks. Because, you know, accountants and bookkeepers would tell us that it's crazy to give money away and that, oh, we should be a registered charity so we can claim some tax benefit from it. Yeah, but we don't do that. So are there any comedians in the audience? We have Daryl Mack in the audience. Daryl, would you like to count our money for us and just make sure that we're honest and we're really giving away $1,000? So we do have the mayor's security team at the door, so. So, Daryl, could you please, you know, count the money?
Count them,
entertain
okay.
Entertain the crowds while we go and pick a winner. Thanks so much.
As a Canadian stand-up comic, I've never held this much money in my hands before. This is a thrill, so we're going to count this. Like, ladies, I've always heard that girls love a guy with a big bank account, and you should see mine. Huge! Lots of room in there. It's like an honor. I'm going to count this out right in front of you. Thanks for coming out tonight, people, because, I mean, the weather out there is enough to shut the streets of Vancouver down. But Calgarians don't care. It's not that we're tougher. We're just in denial. Saw two guys wearing shorts today. That's just odd. A couple days ago, I saw a guy in a European high-performance sports car convertible, and he had the windows up and the top was down with the heat on. It's just a moron with money right there. But I'm a gearhead. I like the nice cars. And I roll down my window and I go, "That's a nice car, buddy." And he goes, "Thanks." I said, "I was going to buy a high-performance sports car, but as a professional entertainer in Canada, I don't need, you know, something like a Ferrari or anything like that, because my penis is huge." I was going to taunt him further, but my bus turned. Let's see how much we've won. 40, 60, 80, 100. I'm going to put it right here just so you guys all know. It's right. We couldn't get all just uniform bills. No, a couple of fives, because Awesome Calgary has been out panhandling for some change here. That's all right. I'm just happy to be home. I did a cross-country trip this summer by motorcycle, almost got mugged at gunpoint in Ontario. They got this big gang there, the OPP. Have you heard of them? Oh, just an unruly bunch they are. That's two. Yeah. I don't know where they train the OPP, because the RCMP are trained in Regina. I don't know if you knew that. That's probably to make them just surly before they let them loose with a radar gun. I cannot imagine what kind of a crazy bad town the OPP have to be in, because this guy, he was practically spitting at me going, "Did you not see that big electronic sign telling you to slow down for construction?" And I had to remind this cop, "Don't you know that in Ontario it's against the law to read a text message while driving?" 300. I feel like I'm paying you guys to do my jokes. This is beautiful. I always have trouble with signs, electronic signs. We got to stop. I was in Banff National Park last week, and maybe it's bilingualism that's going to get me killed, because they had a sign. It's Banff. You got to have both languages. I accept that. Big French message on this electronic sign. And I'm from Alberta, so of course my French is pretty much non-existent. unless they're telling me who the turd star is, I have no idea what's on there. So I'm desperately waiting, because this is 2012. I don't know what's going down. Is there another tsunami? Or maybe the Earth is flipping, rogue planet, the Mayans were correct. And finally gets the English, and I see, warning. Oh, I hope it's zombies. That's all I say. I hope it's zombies. Four. This is awesome. Let's just count this. Five. This is exciting. I feel like I'm doing a down payment on a tent. What are we up to now? I've already lost count. Like a six, seven, 20, 40, 60, 80, 8, 20, 40, 60, 80, 9. 1,000 with the small stuff on top. I'm going to leave it right on that laptop there. Wow, this is, I've never had an accordion band behind me. This is a thrill. I have never had an entire orchestra of accordions. So play a little along to the jokes there if you can. Oh, sorry. I'm not really sure what she was doing, but you were enthusiastic, like the mayor said. So, keep it up there. Love the stools, the buckets. That's awesome. It works. Don't throw it away, man. The buckets. I'm like that. I'm cheap, man. If something kind of works, I don't throw it away. That's why I've got a TV at home where all the channels are in green. Kind of works, so I compensate. I just pretend I'm watching my favorite shows as a Marine doing night ops with those special goggles. Sneaking up on the Jeopardy thing. Everything, that's the way my life is. If something kind of works, I don't throw it away. That's why I was married for 10 years. It's all the married women reacting, yeah, whatever. I have a smoke detector that only goes off when I make toast. I have grease fires licking off the stove up the wall of the kitchen, not a peep out of this little piece of plastic I bought, but if I put two slices of bread down, beep, beep, beep. So it kind of works, so I compensate. Now what I've done is I paneled the inside of my house. All the walls are done with bread. So if a fire breaks out, my toast detector will alert me to the danger, saving me valuable minutes to work on other problems like the fact my house has been invaded by ducks and they're eating my walls. All right. We're getting ready to wrap this up. I think they've done the deliberating. But I want you guys to go out and have fun tomorrow. Do some practical jokes against society. This is your little homework assignment. Do it for me. I love doing stuff just against society without telling them. Like, pretend to be broken down to see if you can show up in the radio traffic reports. You got a parade of cars honking behind you. Move that hunk of junk. You're like, screw you. It's my 15 minutes. I'm a rock star. 3 stations so far. If you're new to the city, it's like a poor man's GPS. There's a blue sedan blocking the eastbound Memorial Overpass. Well, that's where I am. Thank you, helicopter guy. Wow. He is accurate. A lot of happy faces, but you might have a day where you're bummed out, so this is the last one. Do this. Go for job interviews when you don't need the position. Spend a day so you can cut the ad-outs and quote over a bit. Bring a beer. Screw it. You're not getting hired. This will put a smile on your face. Just liquored up 9:30 in the morning. Kick this guy's door open. Hey, boss guy. I'm here. Just reading your little advert. He says you're looking for a slough studer. Sorry, self-starter. That's what it says there. The peepers aren't what they used to be. I saw one ad in the paper that practically leapt off the page. I had to go down and said, telemarketers wanted. So I ran down for the interview and I went through the questions. The guy goes, great, when can you start? And I said, never. I just wanted to waste your time so you knew how it felt. Thank you, Austin, Calgary. I know Lori's around here somewhere. Are we still counting the money? I'd like to thank the payment for my gig. I'm going to put this all back in the book here. Was that the signal for was my wrapped up? They coming back out? Are they coming back out or not? They're coming up. Oh, okay. Do you want to hold on to the money or put it back in the bag?
Yeah, I'll take the money.
Okay, you can take the money.
Okay, I'll put the money in the bag there.
Thanks. So on behalf of Endeavor Arts, my wife Marie and I would like to thank everybody for coming. We'd also like to thank the awesome Calgary Foundation. These guys are incredible. It's just amazing. The first awesome foundation event was held here at the gallery, and we've tried to be as much of a part of this great organization as possible. I just love that, it's the purest form of good. People just donating their own hard-earned cash and just trying to do something, awesome for our city. So I just like everybody to give them a big hand. I'll just say a couple words about our space here. If anybody's interested, we try and have as many events as possible that that promote culture and promote innovation in Calgary. If you're interested, we have a guest book. Feel free to sign up, and we'll let you know about upcoming events. We also have a couple artists here tonight. If you have any questions about anything, there's one of them over there. If you have any questions about anything, feel free to ask me or my beautiful wife, Maria. Thanks, guys, and take it away.
Hey, thanks, Shannon. Run off with the money. So, Shannon and Maria, thank you so much. You've been such gracious hosts to us. This is the third time we've been here, and it's been more fabulous each time. I also want to thank our sponsors from Village Brewery, who are serving beer for you over there. Woo! And this is a happy event, but it's also a little bit of a sad event. It's the last pitch night that John Smiley will be a trustee with us. He's retiring after his first year. But that's why we brought beer for you, because your requirement always was you need to have beer. So for you, John Smiley, this is for you. Yay! So thank you again to all the trustees. Thank you to everyone who pitched. Our next event is May 24th. We haven't officially nailed down the venue yet, so we will announce that, as we always do, on Twitter and on our Facebook page and our website. And we encourage everybody to stay after for a meet and greet. We've got Bike Grocheteria, who's brought some food for us. And you can meet some of our previous winners and talk to the top four and the trustees.
And lots of beer.
And lots of beer. So now I'd like to actually turn the honors over to our mayor, Naheed Nenshi. Thank you.
Thanks, Lori. Now, a politician should never be photographed with a bag with a big dollar sign on it. So, before I announce the winner, and I will tell you that it was a heated debate back there. There was some serious fighting going on. Watch out for Emma Grace's right hook. This is what I'm telling you. In particular, Brian Singh had to explain to all of us exactly why our sample was incorrect. And polling really does work, ladies and gentlemen, says Brian Singh. But before I get to announcing the winner, I just want to say thank you so much to the awesome Calgary Foundation and to the trustees. You know, I always say that we make change in the community not because government does it or because we rely on other people to do it, but when every single one of us uses our own hands, our own hearts, our own resources, and in this case, our own $100 a month, to actually make change in the community. And I think that the Awesome Calgary Foundation is such a great example of that. So thank you, Lori, and the whole team for all you've done for a whole year. Let's celebrate that. Now, I will tell you as well that I am also a guy who celebrates out-of-the-box thinking and new ideas. So I just want you to close your eyes for a second and picture the following. A cookie monster chasing a cookie on ski bikes with an accordion soundtrack through a giant clothing swap event. Everybody's a winner, right? But we did come up with a winner. We did come up with a winner. We learned a bunch of things about, at least I learned a bunch of things about how to do future pitches for future people out there in the audience, because I was listening very carefully to the trustees. So I learned a few things. Number one, if you're going to say take off your clothes, just saying. And number two, without further ado, because this will give it away, yes, ladies and gentlemen, bribing the judges works. Because our winner tonight is the Great Cookie Chase.
I didn't mean bribing the judges with the money. I meant with the cookies. And the trustees were particularly excited, just really more than anything, by the energy and quality of that presentation. Though I do have to point out that one of the trustees did say, "This is what happens when mums don't sew anymore." And another one of the trustees who shall remain unnamed is still really creeped out about what they found on eBay. And I hope that there are lots of parental controls on those computers. Anyway, congratulations, gentlemen.
Thank you.
This is going to be great. We look forward to seeing you. And congratulations to everyone else who pitched, as well as, of course, to the other three finalists. Let's hear it for the other three finalists and the great things that they're doing for the community. Now, just before I want to hand it back to Lori, I want to say thank you all for inviting me and for having me today. My security team, which is Franca, is in fact telling me that I got to get to the next mayor event. So I am out of here, but thank you all so very much.
Thank you very much. Can we do a photo op? Why am I yelling? please help yourself to food and some beverage, and we'll see everyone again next month. Thank you to our loyal followers. I see many of you here tonight. Great event. Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor.